Hi there. I just wanted to clarify a behavior in Gmail that a few people have asked me about lately, so I thought best if we just clear it up. Gmail runs a thing called conversation view, and that means that if you have multiple messages that contain the same subject line, they'll actually be grouped together. So you can see here's one from Katrina, me and Chris, and there's a number 9 after it. That means there have been 9 exchanges on this email, on this thread. If I open a thread, so let's open this one, you'll see that this thread started 6 days ago, and it's been going for a number of days, and I'm just about to reply to this. Now, normally in an unthreaded world where conversation view is turned off, those messages would be scattered throughout my inbox over a period of days. So if I wanted to go back and see the thread of conversation, it's harder to do. Where there's too many messages to show on the screen, it shows you this thing in the middle that says there are 6 older messages, and you can see there's a number of horizontal lines there. If you click on that area, it expands that out and it shows you the entire conversation thread. So this thread started 6 days ago with a message from Katrina, and then I answered, and then Katrina responded, then Chris Waterman weighed in, and then I responded, and so on and so on. So there is a number of people involved. The question I had from people is, if you respond to one of these messages, so here's one from Katrina, for example. This was sent to both me and Chris Waterman, and if I hit the reply button and respond with something like, there you go, found them, blah blah, so there's my response, and I click the send button, the thing that was confusing people is, who does that message go to? Does it go to just Katrina? Does it go to Katrina and Chris? Does it go to everybody who's ever been part of this conversation? The answer is, it goes to whoever you send it to. In this case, it's only going to Katrina. If I wanted to reply to other people, I could do the reply to all and include other people, but I'm not doing that. It's just a reply, and you can see it takes out the other people. So the email behaves in a conversation view exactly the way it behaves in a non-conversation view. It goes to whoever it's supposed to go to. Here's the gotcha. When not just Gmail but any email program replies to a message, it usually quotes previous messages. So here's my response to Katrina. But underneath here, indented with this vertical line to indicate it's a previous message, is her previous reply. And beneath that is my previous reply. And beneath that is her previous reply, and so on. So this quoting of previous messages is actually part of the message itself. Now that's not a Gmail thing. Outlook did exactly the same thing. That's just the way email works. It always quotes previous messages. So if I was to send this message, I'll just click send. That one only went to Katrina. However, if you look at that message by clicking on this little expansion button here where it says show trimmed content, you can see that the previous messages in the thread are still included in the thread. Now that catches people out because it tends to confuse people. They wonder if I'm sending it to one person, is multiple people getting it? No. It goes to whoever you send the mail to, but bear in mind that there may be comments left in the conversation quoting below that are included in the message, even though it's not being sent specifically to that person.